Welcome to this session of Energy Conservation and Management. Myself, Anirban Sarkar, Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department of JIS College of Engineering, Kolkata. We are discussing about the Module 3, that is Total Energy Concept, CHP Cycles and their Applications. Today's session, we will discuss about case studies of caustic soda industry for cogenerations. Learning outcome. The learning outcome of this topic is applications of cogeneration systems applicable in a caustic soda industry which has extraction cum back pressure steam turbine. The extraction cum back pressure steam turbine caustic soda industry. Steam turbine cogeneration plant is based on the cogeneration system in the soda ash manufacturing continuous process chemical plant. The soda ash process is one of the highly energy intensive chemical process requiring power as well as steam almost same proportion. That is, the ratio of power to heat would be nearly one. Generally, in soda ash plant, the extraction cum back pressure type steam turbine based cogeneration system and fired boiler are found working, providing the best performance result due to achievement of extremely good heat balance due to excellent utilization of energy in two different forms. The high pressure boilers are generally fired with coal or lignite or fuel oil. The case study is provided below is based on the system working in one of the largest soda ash plant existing in Gujarat state. The equipment, the captive power plant consists of major equipment details below. 3 number of extraction cum back pressure type single stage steam generator sets as per ratings provided below. That is, 2 numbers are 11,000 kilowatt single extraction cum back pressure and 1 number is 4200 kilowatt double extraction cum back pressure. Four number of lignite cum coal fired steam generator as per ratings given below. That is 3 into 70 TPH, 105 kg per centimeter square, 405 degree centigrade. And 1 into 50 TPH, 105 kg per centimeter square and 405 degree centigrade operating temperature. Cogeneration equipment data is mentioned below, that is steam turbine generator data first of all, number of installation rating and speed of the turbine respectively is for the 2 steam turbine of extraction cum back pressure of same ratings, that is 11,000 kilowatt, speed of that turbine is 8250. That is 2 number, and another third turbine, that is extraction cum back pressure also, that is number of installation is 1, rating is 4200 kilowatt and speed of the turbine is 11,500 rpm. speed ratio 8250 by 3000 and 11500 by 1500 respectively. The inlet steam pressure is same, that is 105 kg per centimeter square. Temperature 500 degree centigrade. Steam flow rate 135 and 28.5 for the two sets respectively. Specific steam consumption, that is not available this data. Now, the fast extraction steam parameter, steam pressure is 40 kg per centimeter square, temperature 390 degree centigrade. Steam flow rate 50 ton per hour and 2 ton per hour respectively. And for the second extraction steam parameter, that is steam pressure 22 kg per centimeter square, steam temperature 325 degree centigrade, and steam flow, that is 12.9 TPH, that is ton per hour. Now, backup pressure steam parameter, that is 22 and 2.2 kg per centimeter square respectively, steam temperature 290 and 161 degree centigrade, steam flow, that is 85 and 13.7 ton per hour respectively. The generator's data, rating for apparatus apparent power, that is 13750 kilovolt, that is 11000 kilowatt. And for the second set of extraction come back pressure turbine, that one is 4200 kilowatt. The generation voltage are same, that is 6600 volts. The power factor is also same, that is taken as 0.8, and frequency 50 hertz. Generator shaft speed, that is 3000 and 1500 RPM. Steam generated data, it is seen that MCR steam flow, that is 70 TPH respectively each, pressure 105 kg per centimeter square, temperature 505 degree centigrade, flue gas temperature entering the chimney, that is 150 degree maximum in both cases, feed water temperature also same, that is 150 degree centigrade. Shoot blowers are provided in both the cases. The fuel consumption and fuel specification technical relevant data, flow rate of fuel, that is 9.34 metric ton per hour lignite and 4 metric ton per hour coal. CV of the fuel, that is 3894 and 5832 kilojoule kilocalorie per kilojoule respectively. Moisture content present in lignite more, that is 32.16, and for coal 5.18. Carbon 31.78 and 64.07 respectively. Hydrogen percentage in weight per weight of the 3.48 and 5.17 respectively. The nitrogen, oxygen, the other and the ash content are also respectively given. Ratio of fuel mixing maintained for firing, that is 7:3. Fuel gross calorific value based on 7:3 ratio considered for performance, that is 4200 kilocalorie per kg. Next is normal operating philosophy. The soda ash plant is working round the clock, having very critical continuous chemical process. Interruptions of more than half an hour in availability of energy, either in the form of electric power or steam, creates enormous problem in the ongoing process, resulting into substantial production losses. One of the major process areas requiring power is lime kiln, which must be kept burning under adverse circumstances. Otherwise, it proves disastrous if the kiln dies down. In the steam of soda ash as final product, the screw compressor gets jammed due to hygroscopic nature of the chemical. So, two number of continuously rotating calciners are another drive requiring uninterrupted power and steam. In the case study provided, one number of 11,000 kilowatt steam turbine generator and 4,200 kilowatt steam generator, along with three number of 70 TPH boilers, are operated at around 80 to 85% of rated capacity. One number of 11,000 kilowatt steam turbine and one of the boiler are kept as standby to take into service either in the event of breakdown or maintenance shutdown of any of the running unit. The standby is considered essential in view of criticality of chemical process and to avoid production loss on this account. The captive power plant starts meeting requirement of electric power and steam of the plant as soon as the production process is commenced. With starting of process equipment in sequence, the power load increases, which provides more and more steam to process. Entire scheme is so designed that power and steam requirement increases hand in hand, maintaining good efficiency of this captive power plant. The heat balance achieved is excellent. The plant is working conforming to the concept of total cogeneration power plant technology, which is encouraged all around the world in a big way due to conformance to very vital concept of energy conservation. Next is utilization of energy available in extraction back pressure steam. Steam injection to steam turbine at 105 kg per centimeter square, 505 degree centigrade. High pressure steam at 105 kg per centimeter square, 505 degree centigrade temperature available from the boiler is sent to a common header and from header to the steam turbine as follows. Three boilers are operated out of four number of installed. 11,000 kilowatt steam turbine generator, that is 135 TPH, normally operated at 9,000 kilowatt load. 4,200 kilowatt steam turbine generator at 28.5 TPH, normally operated at 3,000 kilowatt load. The steam turbine generates around 12,000 kilowatt electric power, which is utilized in the plant production activity, office area, illumination, and also in the housing colony. This is the primary utilization of heat energy available in the steam. Steam at 40 kg per centimeter square for both 11,000 kilowatt steam turbine and 4,200 kilowatt steam turbine, pressure is maintained. And the steam at 40 bar pressure is taken out via extraction as follows. From 11,000 kilowatt steam turbine generator, extraction of steam takes place 50 TPH, 40 kg per centimeter square at 380 degree centigrade. From 4,200 kilowatt steam turbine generator, fast extraction takes place at 2 TPH, 40 kg per centimeter square and 380 degree centigrade. The extension steam is utilized as follows. This extraction steam is injected into three number of back pressure steam turbines, which drives the screw compressors used to compress CO2 for send to the process. The back pressure steam turbine provides the low pressure steam at 2.2 kg per centimeter square, 161 degree centigrade temperature, which is taken to 2.2 bar steam header. To further optimize the utilization of 40 kg per centimeter square bar steam, around 4 TPH steam is injected into a back pressure steam turbine, which drives a large capacity boiler feed water pump, common for all the boiler. Under normal plant running condition, HT motor driven BF pumps is utilized only during startup of first boiler or during maintenance or breakdown of turbine driven feed pump. Again, back pressure steam turbine provides the low pressure steam at 2.2 kg per centimeter square, 150 degree centigrade temperature, which is diverted to 2.2 kg per centimeter square pressure header for further utilization of heat in the processes. The utilization of steam to drive the plant auxiliaries have resulted into substantial saving of electricity energy, which would have been otherwise required to drive very high capacity compressor and large capacity of BF pumps using electric motor as a prime mover. Steam at 22 kg per centimeter square and 8 kg per centimeter square, that is deaerated steam. The steam at 22 kg per centimeter square pressure is available in the system as follows from both the steam turbine in operation. For 11,000 kilowatt steam turbine generator, back pressure or exhaust steam, 85 TPH, 22 kg per centimeter square pressure and 280 degree centigrade. From 4,200 kilowatt steam turbine generator, second extraction steam takes place at 12.8 TPH, 22 kg per centimeter square, 325 degree centigrade. The exhaust and extraction steam is utilized as follows, though through 22 kg per centimeter square bar pressure header. Major part of steam is utilized two number of calciners for calcination process of soda ash. The steam is passed through desulfurizing station to reduce the temperature to 230 degree centigrade, which is marginal loss of energy. Part of steam is absorbed to convert sodium bicarbonate to sodium carbonate. the chemical reactions that is given 2NaCHCO3 plus H2O equal to N2CO3 plus 2HO. And balance come out as condensate from calcium. Thus, for steam used in reaction, all heat available in 22 bar steam is utilized. 22 bar steam condensed as mentioned in above A is flashed to convert to 8 bar 205 degree centigrade steam. This steam is sent to the deaerator as pegging steam. Mostly the deaerator steam is supplied in this manner and shortfall, if any, is supplied through 22 or 8 bar PRDS as and when required. This system saves good amount of energy. Direct draw of steam from boiler for deaeration is totally avoided. Some part of 22 bar steam is supplied to HP feed water heater for heating of boiler feed water before it sent to the boiler, and steam condensate available in HP heater is sent to the deaerator for feeding to the boiler. A part of 22 bar steam is directly sent to the process area for direct utilization of heat. The heat is almost utilized in the processes and condensate is recovered and sent to the deaerator. Steam at 2.2 bar. The steam at 2.2 bar is available as from the following, that is from 4200 kilowatt steam turbine generator, back pressure or exhaust steam, 13.7 TPH, 2.2 kg per centimeter square and 161 degree centigrade. From three number of steam turbine driven driving carbon dioxide compressor exhaust 48 TPH and 2.2 bar and 161 degree centigrade. From steam turbine driving to boiler feed pump exhaust 4 TPH 2.2 kg per centimeter square and 150 degree centigrade. The exhaust and extraction steam is utilized as follows through 2.2 kg per centimeter square heater. The steam available at 2.2 bar from heater is utilized in the process for heating purpose to its condensing temperature. As such, almost all energy available is utilized and the condensate is sent back to the deaerator for ongoing feeding to the boiler. Steam drawn to pressure relief deaerator valve. A number of PRDS is installed. However, these are taken in service in the event of emergency. When the steam is certain level may not be available due to non-availability of steam turbine generator or mechanical drive turbine, except 22 or 8 bar PRDS, other PRDS are not operated under normal situation to save energy. This point is also worth noting. Utilization of electric power. When the plant production is normal, 4200 kilowatt steam turbine and one of the 11,000 kilowatt steam turbine are operated, maintaining the electric power load of around 12 megawatt out of total capacity of 15 megawatt available, depending on number of equipment taking parts in the process and the colony load. The grid power is kept as standby. 4200 kilowatt steam turbine is utilized to turn the nearly 80% its respective capacity, so that the steam extraction at different level and back pressure is available, which would provide better efficiency. The variation in part plant load is absorbed by 11,000 kilowatt steam turbine generator. If 2.2 bar level steam would be obtained through pressure reducing cum superheating station, there would be loss of heat energy available in high pressure steam sent to PRDS, that is pressure reducing cum de superheating station. Now come to the plant performance analysis, that is power plant analysis of the plant. Electric generation output, that is 12,000 kilowatt converted into kilojoule per hour, that is 431,37,600 kilojoule per hour. Steam output, 22 bar process, quantity 15 metric ton per hour, and energy carried is given. So as a total energy in the steam output, that is 31,81,87,452 kilojoule per hour. Total energy output, that is electricity per steam, that will be total 42,35,44,352 kilojoule per hour. Now fuel input, as we know, that is lignite 9.34 and coal 4 metric ton per hour. High heating value, that is for lignite and coal respectively, is 3894 and 5832 gross calorific value. Now, while we calculate the total energy input, that will give us 7487,20,294 kilojoule per hour. Overall efficiency, that is equal to 56.6%. Based on plant operating data available for the cogeneration plant, the performance indicators are observed as follows. 11,000 kilowatt steam turbine generator, that is first or second. Plant load factor 85-90 and overall efficiency 57%. 4200 kilowatt steam turbine generator, that is operating as all these steam turbines are operating at 70 TPH boiler. 3 number out of 4 number is run all the time. The data for efficiency of boiler is provided to supplement the overall very good efficiency level maintained by the plant. And all the 4 boilers while running, that is at 70 TPH, 105 bar and 505 degree centigrade temperature, the efficiency varies from 75% to 80% for first boiler. Second boiler, that is 76% to 80%, third boiler 80% to 82%, and fourth boiler is 82% to 85%, which is nearly more or less same rated capacity. The power load on the steam turbine generator is maintained to optimum feasible level to achieve better performance. The steam load is maintained accordingly on the operated boiler. As such, the plant load factor and efficiency observed very good for this specific system. The power load variations are generally taken care of by 11,000 kilowatt steam turbine generator, maintaining almost full load on 4200 kilowatt steam turbine generator. No parallel operations with the grid is carried out. The average age of the steam turbine 1 and 2 and boiler 1, 2 and 3 around 16 years. Steam turbine 3 and 4 are relatively new, taken into service before around 8 years. There is provision of online weighing scale at starting point for conveyors for measurement of actual quantity of coal and lignite fired in the boiler. Moreover, the bunker levels are also monitored. The instrumentation system for measuring the steam flow and total quantity is installed dedicated by each boiler. Thus, necessary data for steam generation via fuel is generated for the CPP plant. For power measurement, usually calibrated energy meters are installed, decided to each generator. All these measuring and monitoring systems greatly supplement effort to keep a watch on the performance of this CPP. The heat balance diagrams are shown here, which is, that is, first of all, from 105 bar steam header is feeding the steam to the back pressure turbine. From this back pressure turbine, there are two points of tapping, that is at 40 bar steam header and it is going to 22 bar steam header. From 40 bar steam header, it is again going to some back pressure turbine, that is from 2 to 2.2 bar steam header, and the steam is bypassed to turbine driven boiler feed pump, that is a part of power is utilized. From 2.2 bar steam header, it is moving to the process, that is calcinate return from the process, and from the other side 22 bar steam headers, the steam is coming and it is going to the main calciner process to run the heat pump feed water heater and to the process of the PRTS, and ultimately it is going to the flash steam natural from the calciner. Now, this is steam generation and distribution systems. These flow diagram are as follows. So here it is shown number of turbines and the corresponding processes. These are the references. With this, we would like to conclude today's session. Thank you for joining this session.